smallest, and this one is the largest entry in the data set. So what is the range? The range is the difference between 12.03 and 3.22. And when you subtract 12.03, you don't need a calculator. We don't need a calculator for that, but 3.22, I got 8.81. So the range of the data is 8.81. Now, I'm asking myself, how many classes should I select, should I use? Because based on the number of classes, I will determine the width of the class, of each class. And remember, normally between 5 and 20 classes. So we do have several options here. Looking at back at the data, so I'm going to share again so we can look at the data together. Let's see, before we make a decision on how many classes. So let's see how many entries I have, let's say between 3 and 4. Between 3 and 4, I have 16 entries, right? Between 3 and 4. Okay, let's see how many we have between 4 and 5. Between 4 and 5, a big chunk. Between 5 and 6, not as many. Between 6 and 7, just one. Between 7 and 8, just one. Between 9 and 10, nothing. Between 10 and 11, I have two. Then I have two between 11 and 12, and I have one at the very end. So what if we consider two options and compare? Sometimes we do have to select two options and see how the data looks like. So let's say we select, I'm going to stop sharing. Let's say we select five classes and see how the look of the histogram, and then also 10 classes.
Could you move the paper down just a little bit? Thank you.
Is that okay? So we determine the range. If we use 10 classes, for example, for 10 classes, the width with 10 classes will be 8.81 divided by 10. So that will be roughly 0.8. With the width with 5 classes will be 8.81 divided by 5, which is roughly double of that, right? It's 1.6. Okay, so we have a starting point. Let's go back to StatCrunch. Is this okay, everyone? So I determined the range. I sorted the data from the smallest to the largest. I determined the range. And now the question is, I have to select the number of classes in order to determine the width of the class. Having the range, select the number of classes. I may look at two different categories, two different histograms, one with 5 and one with 10. So the one with 10, I'm going to start with the one with 10 because it's easier. It doesn't matter. I can enter any number in StatCrunch. So 10 classes with 0.8 and 5 classes with 1.6. Okay, so let's go to, I'm going to share again. Okay, so let's go to graph, and we want to create a histogram. And it's going to ask us, you can use the raw data or you can use the sorted, it doesn't matter. Start at, where do I want the histogram to start? Of course at 3, because 3.22 is the smallest. So I'm going to put 3. What is the width? It's 0.8, but I'm going to put 1. I want a frequency, and that's really all I need. Now I'm going to put the x-axis. I'm going to call it rate. I'm going to use the frequency. And I'm going to compute. And that's what I get. See the gaps? We knew that we were going to have gaps in there because between certain, for certain classes, we didn't have any entries. Okay? That's our histogram with a frequency. Now, if we want to go back and create another, and we can have them side by side and see which one is better, go to another histogram. This time, I'm still using the same. I want the still frequency. I want this time the starting point. Goodbye. Start at, of course, 3. I want the width this time to be 2 or 1.6. I want the same thing. I want to label rate. I want to label frequency. You can do the relative frequency, of course. And I want to compute. And I want to look at these two side by side. And I, of course, I do have a question. Which one do you think is a better option? The one with 5 classes? Okay, we can change anything, right? We can change to 20 classes. We can change to 15 classes, anything. But what do you think, what is your option? What would you prefer? Would you prefer the frequency, the histogram with 10 classes, or the one with 5? If the data appear to be too lumped, and you can differentiate, you don't have enough details, you would say no to one or the other. Which one do you prefer? Would you prefer the one with 5 classes, or you prefer one with 10? Which one speaks to you more? Sorry. Anyone?
Doesn't it depend on how many details you want?
That is true, but the one with 5 classes, you're correct. The one with 5 classes does not show me that here it's completely blank, right? Between 7 and 8 and between 9 and 10, it does not say that. Although I see it's very low. It's really not differentiating between these two, and there is a difference between those two. Intervals, classes if you want, but for continuous data we call them intervals. I would definitely prefer the one with 10 classes. Of course we can go back and change and we can do 20 classes and see how it looks like. So we say we have the frequency, it's like the trace button in the graphing calculator, the frequency is 29, between 3 and 5 we have 29. Same thing here. More details, right? Between 4 and 5 we have 13. Here we wouldn't be able to differentiate. We would not know how many between 4 and 5 or 3 and 4. Good, perfect so far. Any questions for me? Any questions? So I'm going to stop sharing. So here's where we are. We enter the data. We have a frequency. We created the classes. We prefer 10 classes with a width of 0.8, but I entered 1 because it was easier, of course, the width of 1. We constructed a frequency and a relative frequency. We didn't do the relative frequency, but we can go back and do the relative frequency. The next item in line, another way of presenting data, is a stem and leaf plot. Okay? So for example 11, I want to show how to do this by hand. But I will be using the sorted data. So I will look at StatCrunch to to use the sorted data, because I did not write it, I didn't put it in writing. Okay. So, as I mentioned before, so that's the step, the next stem and leaf plot. A stem and leaf plot is another way of presenting the data in a summarized form. We're going to enter all the numbers in ascending order. That's why I needed the sorted. So 3, 2, 2. Actually, we prefer, I'm gonna erase that. We prefer just using one final digit in the right column. So I'm going to enter 3.22. The next one is 3, meaning 3.23. The next entry, and I will have all the data set entered in one spot. The stem and leaf plot recovers the entire data, everything. The histograms, as you see, data is hidden. I don't have the entire data. But the stem and leaf plot is another way of presenting, summarizing the data set. So 3.2, 2, 3.2, 3. Next one, 3.2, 4, 3.2, 5, 3.2, 7, 3.2, 8, 8 again. Then I move on to 3.3, 3.3, 0. 3.3, 3.3, 0, 3.3, 3.4 is next, 3.4 and 5, 3.4 nothing, 3.5 and 3, 3.5 and 4, 3.5 and 4 again, 3.5 and 7, 3.98 alone, 4. 0.04, 4.1, 4.18, 1.19, and I continue till I finish the entire data. What does this tell me? It tells me that 3.2 so far I didn't finish, but for this part of the stem and leaf, what I can say is that 3.2 and one more digit has the most occurrences. What, which one is next in line? Is the 3, 5, and 3. So 3.5 is the next occurrence, most number of occurrences, the highest. And then I see that this will be the lowest with the 5, 3.45, just 1, 3.981, 4.041 entry. And at the level of 4.1, I have 2. Let me share. Again, another way of summarizing, learning about the data. So let's go to graph. And we have the stem and leaf. Stem and leaf. We want the variable, the raw variable. It doesn't matter. You can use a sorted variable. It's not important. Just make sure, this is an important item for the stem and leaf plot, please make sure you click on none for the outlier trimming. So write it down if you need to. For the outlier trimming, just click on none and then compute. And here it is. Any questions? Any questions? As you see, StatCrunch created the stem. This is the stem, and these are the leaves. Stem is the core, if you want, right here. It created a split. It created a split type of stem and leaf. Anything below 5 was in one leaf for 3. Anything in a above 5 or more in a second leaf. So it created 2 leaves for 3. It created 2 leaves for 4. A stem of 4 written twice and 2 leaves for 5-1. So this is another way of saying, okay, I don't see anything between 6 and 8. I don't see anything between 9 and 10. And there is nothing at 11 point and below 5. So the focus of the data is up here, between clearly between 3 and 5, and the rest are much lower. You could say, what about the shape of the distribution? Here is some type of shape that I'm looking at, which is skewed to the right. It's pulled to the right. It has a long tail to the right. If you look at it upside, sideways. Yep. Very good. I'm going to stop sharing. Okay, so that was the stem and leaf. So we already did with the example, with the data from example 11. Now, finally, we get to dot plots. We have 2 options now, because we are down to 2 to 10 minutes. So it's up to you if you want to take our quiz today. If you don't want to take the quiz today, then I'll finish up the lesson. I created 3 questions, and I presented the data here, because from copying it from Canvas will be difficult for you. So this is the data set for our quiz for today. We can leave it for Monday if you don't want to do it today, for easy access and calculations. So you can cross them out, and you can calculate or add or find the frequency, because you cannot do that in Canvas. So you want to finish the lesson, or you want to stop and look at the quiz? You want to leave the quiz for Monday? We can leave the quiz for Monday.
Finish the lesson, please.
We want to finish the lesson? Yes? Okay, perfect.
And if everyone wants, okay.
Let's finish the lesson. Okay. And you want to do the quiz on Monday. Is that what you said? Okay, perfect. No problem. I will extend it. You can start working on it. So that will be great. You have that over the weekend if you like. It's just 3 easy questions. Okay, and you have the data here. So it's easy for you to perform operations with it, add whatever, cross it out, and so on and so forth. I copied it for you here. That's the 3rd question, I think. Okay, so finally, the dot plots. So let's go back to here. I copied again the data set from Wendy's. I already have it sorted out in StatCrunch as well as in my calculator. So I'm not using this. I'm using the sorted one, in which I know each category. So here's how we create the dot plot. Which page am I on? I think I'm on 5. Okay, so here's the dot plot. We know that the data is somewhere between 1 and 12. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'll make it shorter. And for each entry, we're going to put a dot. Every time we see an entry, we put a dot for it. But I already have it sorted, so I'm going to put the dots quite fast. Here they are. So one customer has only one dot. 2 customers have 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's for 2. For 3 customers, only one dot. 1 appearance. For 4 customers, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. For 5 customers, I have 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They have to be all in order, same height, so that I can compare them. Because if I put one here and let's say five here, but then I have six the next one and I put them here, that's not correct, right? They have to be in order. So the same height, number one at the same height, number two at the same height, number three at the same height, number four at the same height, number five, six, and seven. Okay, moving on. So that's for five. For six, I have 11. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. It's the highest anyway, so I'm not going to get that high. So seven, five, one, two, three, four, five. For eight, I have two. For nine, I have two. And for 11, that's 10, 11, not 12. For 11, I only have one. So that's the dot plot. Can I say anything about it? Yes, I can. I can say that something like that. It's not bell-shaped. Appears to be a little bit skewed to the right. Not particular type of distribution that I have much to say about. Good. Finally, let's do this with our data. Let's share quickly so we can do that too. So, graph, dot plot. I'm not doing it with Wendy's, so let me do it with Wendy's as I promised. Okay, I'm saving. Yes, I'm saving. So I go back to my data set right here. We have it. We entered both. We'll go back to them. Please save them so you have them. Go back to Wendy's. Okay. Let's go to graph, and I want to graph on, in my case, variable 5. So I go to dot plot. I want, yes. Go ahead, please.